Welcome, Clarity Coders. In today's video, we're going to jump into the world of Repl.it and create a Reddit bot that runs 24/7, streams in live comments, and then replies with some funny jokes to those comments to get you some of that sweet karma. In this video, we're going to cover this line by line so you know exactly how to create this bot. And if Reddit really isn't your thing, this will be applicable to whatever you're trying to do, whether that's create a Discord bot, stream, scrape Facebook or some other site, whatever you want to do, we're going to show you how to do it. With Repl.it, we have some serious advantages. We're not going to have to download or install anything on our computer, so if you're brand new to programming, this is the perfect time to jump in. And by the end of it, you'll be able to create some of your own programming application. Let's not waste any more time and jump right in. The first thing we're going to do is sign up for Repl.it. It's really easy to use, and it's super useful for any project you really want to get into. So whether you're doing the office bot with us or something else, this is a good place to start. You're going to just hit sign up, select how you want to sign up. I'm going to sign up using my Gmail account. You can sign up however you would like, and you should come to a screen like this once you're completed. You're going to go over here and click on My Repls. Click on Python, which is what we're going to use today. And you can call this whatever you want. You can call it Reddit bot. I'm going to call mine Office bot because I'm going to make a comment reply bot using quotes from the office. Once you get it created, you should come to a screen like this. And over here right away, I'm going to adjust my settings for this video. I'm going to change my indent size just so it's a little more readable. And I'm also going to change my font size again, just so it's more readable for you guys. You don't have to change these if you don't want. And I'm also going to adjust my view to be stacked, again, just to help with your viewing purposes here. And now we can go ahead and jump in here and start coding. Now we're going to create a Reddit bot. So right away, we're going to import the library pra. That's going to be what we're going to use, the API we're going to use to access Reddit. Now to use this API, we're going to have a Reddit account, which I've shown in other videos, and we're also going to have to set up some developer credentials. I'll show you these here, but it's really easy. You basically just have to sign up for a Reddit account, go to this URL, enter these values, and then you should have credentials ready for this script. One important note with Repl.it is you're going to create a public project if you're on the free account. So you need to keep that in mind and keep your credentials out of any of your Python files or anything like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new file called .env, and in here is where we're going to store our credentials. Now this probably goes without saying, but do not copy my credentials. They're not going to work for you. So you have to sign up and create your own. We're going to use a client ID, a client secret, a username, and a password. You can get those from the credentials you set up. So if you look here, you can see we have a client ID that we can grab out, and I'll just paste that in. We can grab out our client secret. I'll paste that in as well. You need to grab your username, obviously. Again, don't use mine. It won't work for you. And then whatever your password is. Once that's done, we're going to move back into our main.py. And now to get this bot working, the first thing we want to do is see if we can get comments streaming in. We want to look at a comment, and if someone sets us up for a joke or a quote, then we're going to reply with a quote from the office. We're going to import OS so we can pull in that credential file, and now we'll set up our Reddit API. Here we're going to do basically the same thing we did before. We're going to set our client ID equal to os.getenv. That'll pull in that env file, and we're going to look for the variable that we called it in the other file. We called it client_ID. We kept those the same, so you can pretty much copy those over. So I'm going to steal this line a couple more times for our other value. Now, the last one we actually didn't put in that file because it's not private. So you do have to pass in a user agent and you have to name that. You can name it pretty much whatever you want. I'm going to show you the syntax that Reddit suggests that you use here. So I'm just going to name mine reply comment bot 1.0. Now we're going to make these match the other fields from our file. So we're going to do client secret and username and password. I'll just copy and paste these over because we name them the same as what I'm naming the variables here. Now we have our Reddit instance set up. Now this is going to work as long as you are using your credentials and all that jazz. Now we're going to see if we can get some comments streaming in. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a subreddit that I want to get comments from. For right now, I'll pull from Funny. We might use some others down the road. One thing you do want to do is you do want to set up a subreddit. Next, we're going to grab out our comments as they stream in. So we're going to say for comment in subreddit.stream.comments. And we're going to say to skip the existing comments. So basically what this is going to do is it's going to watch the subreddit in real time. And every time someone comments on any post, it's going to spit it out to us. And we'll just print that to the screen for right now so we can see that it's working. Now, as we wait for these to come in, you can see that it's installing our libraries. And once we start getting comments here, we can start thinking about how this is going to work. If we see a phrase inside a comment that someone posts, then we're going to reply with a funny comment related to that phrase with a quote from The Office using my favorite character, Dwight. Now you can see here, we're pulling in live comments. I'm sure there will be some offensive ones, so watch out for that. I'll try to edit those out. Now that we have that part working, let's look at our CSV. So I created a CSV of phrases and then responses. Now, I made this from The Office, so I stole some quotes from The Office. And basically, in the first column, they're my setup, what I'm looking for on the Reddit comment itself, and then in column B is what I'm going to reply with. So for example, if anywhere in someone's comment they say, "What is bread?" I'm going to reply to that comment, "Bread is the paper of the food industry. You write your sandwich on it," which is a quote Dwight Schrute says. Now you can change these up to whatever you want. Now obviously, if you're looking for something really common in column A, it's going to comment a lot. So we're going to throw in some cooldown periods as well. So for example, if you put basketball in column A and that was it, then whatever you put in column B, it's going to reply. It's going to find that a lot because there's probably a lot of talk going on about, or a lot of times on Reddit that someone's mentioned the word basketball. Now if I open the same file in Notepad, you can see that it's just a simple CSV. So it's comma separated values. There's your first value is the phrase, then a comma, and then your second value. Like you can see on the first line, sometimes the reply or the phrase might have a comma in it, and we don't want the CSV to think that that's a new field, so we put that all inside of quotes. Now that we have that done, we're just going to add that to our project. Now you can drag and drop, or you can click the upload button on the top. I have this CSV on my GitHub if you would like to use the same one, or you can create your own. I suggest starting with the one that I used just to make sure it works and then branching out from there. Now we're going to go ahead and start creating our class. And I'm going to call my class RedditBot, and we're going to define some methods here. We're going to use an init method to set up our bot originally. We're going to pass it in self and then the file name. So this is going to point to our pairs.csv file eventually. We'll just pass for right now while we set up the skeleton of this class. We're going to add another method that we're going to call find_match. This we're going to pass a comment to eventually and try and match it with a phrase. We'll pass for right now. Then we're going to find another function that we're going to use called cooldown. This is going to allow us a way to check to see if we've recently posted to that phrase so we don't keep spamming the same thing over and over again. And finally, we're actually going to create a function called make underscore reply. This obviously is going to be the spot where we actually post our comment if we find a match and all the stuff that we previously mentioned. Now let's go ahead and try and import our comments here. So let's store all of our comments in a response list. So this is just going to be a simple list that's going to be indexed 0 to however many different key value pairs we have. So now let's open our file name. You can name this whatever you want. I'm using the variable CSV underscore file. And we're also going to use the CSV library. So we're going to import CSV to help us read in this file. Now we're going to set up our CSV reader. It's pretty simple. We're basically just going to pass in the delimiter that we used in our file, so what breaks up the different fields. And in ours, it was the comma. So we're just going to pass in delimiter equals and then comma inside of quotes. Then we're going to say for row in our CSV reader. So this is going to pass us back one row, so one line from our file. And then we're going to append that value into our list that we had above. Now I'm going to append these in as a dictionary. So we're going to have key value pairs here. The first one is going to be called our phrase. Now the phrase is what was in column A. So we're going to grab that out of row and it's in the zero index. The second we're going to call our reply. So this is what we're actually going to respond or comment with. This was in the B column, which is in the one index. So we're going to grab that out of the row at the one index. So inside of our response list, we're going to have a bunch of dictionaries, one for each row in our CSV file. And each of those dictionaries will have a key of phrase and a key of reply. Now, eventually, we're going to also add in the last time we posted. And we're going to use that so, again, we don't keep spamming the same comment over and over again. So when we post a comment, we're going to add a field into there that says last time posted. Now to make sure this works, let's just print out our response list and see what it looks like. Down here, we're actually going to create our bot. So we're going to say bot equals Reddit bot. Remember, we said we had to pass in a file name. So we're going to pass in pairs.csv. This isn't a variable, so we're going to highlight, push quote. There we go. And we can go ahead and try and run this. Now it's going to install our new packages because we added an import for CSV. So it's going to go through the install. And then once that's complete, you can see it did spit out our entire response list to the screen. So it looks like it's working. We've pulled in our phrases. We'll go ahead and stop this. And now we're going to work on our find match. So we're going to pass in one of these comments. And instead of printing this out down here, let's actually call that function. So we're going to call find match and we're going to pass in the whole comment. Notice we're not passing in the comment body because eventually we're going to make replies to it and stuff. So we're passing in the entire comment object. And this is on our bot that we created above. So we're going to do bot.findMatch. Now up here, when we have a comment, we want to iterate over all of our dictionaries and see if we have a phrase that matches. So let's iterate over our entire response list. So we're going to say for, you can name this variable whatever you want. I'm going to say dictionary because we're going to get back a dictionary every time. In self.response list. So this is going to grab them out one phrase and reply at a time. We're going to enumerate this as well so we can keep track of the index value. So add I comma in front of dictionary. So this is going to give us what index position the phrase and reply are at in our actual list. So now we're going to say if dictionary, and remember we named the key phrase. If that phrase is in our comment.body, then that's when we want to do something, right? So for right now, let's just print out our comment.body. So I'm going to delete out this response list. And I'm also going to grab from all instead of funny. Now, this will be every single subreddit, which I told you not to do, but we're not going to actually post right now, so it's fine. And you'll see that if you run this for a while, even though you're getting all the comments on all of Reddit, you're not going to get very many matches. Now, that comes back to what I mentioned before. Right now, the capitalization, the quotes, everything inside the phrase and the comment body have to be identical for it to return a match. We don't want that. We don't care if it's different capitalization or something. So let's define a helper method above. So we're going to do def clean underscore string. We're going to pass in a raw string. So we'll say raw underscore string. The first thing that we want to do is let's just make it all lowercase. That way capitalization doesn't matter. So we're going to say clean string equals raw underscore string dot lower. And then on the next line, I'm going to paste in some regex magic here. So you can copy this from the GitHub as well. Essentially, what we're going to do is we're going to remove anything that isn't a alphanumeric character or a space. So essentially, I don't care if there's a quote symbol or something like that. I still want to count it as a match. Then after we get our string cleaned, we can just return that clean string. And we also need to import re, which is the regex library. Now, we need to call this method on our phrases as well as the comment body to make sure they're both cleaned. Now, when we pull these into our field, remember we want to clean that string. We don't need to clean our reply. We're not testing it for matches, so we'll leave the capitalization and all that good in there. And then we also want to clean the body, so we're going to go clean underscore string and wrap that around the comment body as well. Now, hopefully we get a lot more matches. Now, if you run this now and wait a little bit, it'll depend on how often comments are coming in. You can see that stuff will start to print out. Of course, it picks a dirty comment, so I'm going to have to edit that out. But you can see that we are making matches. Now, obviously, we're not posting anything yet, which is good because we're still in the all subreddit, which I don't recommend for bots. Let's go ahead and stop this. Now we're going to add our check to see if the cooldown phase has passed. So what I don't want to do is make the same comment over and over again because you'll get flagged as a bot. So I want to make sure I haven't posted this reply in 24 hours, say. And I'm going to pass in the I value that I got from our response list. So I know what the I value is, what the location of the phrase and reply is in my response list. So I'm going to pass that to my cooldown check. And this is a method on the class, so we're gonna have to do self.cooldown. So we know we have a match, now we need to check to see if we posted it. Now our first check is going to be to see if we've posted this comment at all. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our dictionary, we're gonna say that equals self.response list at whatever the index value is we passed in. Remember, we know which phrase and reply we're working with here. Oops, sorry, it's a little jumpy. And then we're going to say if last posted is not in our dictionary.keys. So this means if it doesn't exist, if that key doesn't exist in the dictionary, we've never posted this comment before. So we can return true because it's going to be okay to post this because we've never done it before. Else we need to do some checks, right? So now if we did post, we know there's a last posted value, and we're going to set that up as a date time in the future. So let's see what the date time is now. We're going to have to import date time. So we'll do from date time, import date time. So here we're going to see what the current date time is, and then we can compare that to the last posted value, which will be the date time that we originally posted the comment. So we're going to say our duration is now minus whatever is in our dictionary. Remember, we know there's a last posted because of the if statement. So we can say minus dictionary at the key of last posted. Now let's get out how many seconds that is. So I'm going to say duration underscore seconds equals duration dot total seconds. That's a method, so we're going to call it with parentheses. Now in the next line, let's convert that to hours. So the hours, we're going to divide whatever the seconds are by 3,600, which is going to give us how many hours it's been since we last posted this. You can make your check whatever you want it to be. I'm going to make mine 24 hours between posts. If hours is greater than or equal to 24, then we're going to return true. Now remember, this is just for that specific phrase and reply. So it's not 24 hours between your bot posting, it's 24 hours between it doing that specific post, like the bread post. Now that we got a value there, we can do our self.makeReply. And we can pass it the comment. Then we can go down to our last method. Sorry, this interface is pretty jumpy. Now we gotta add that we're gonna receive a comment in here. And then we'll use that to make a post. We're also gonna pass in the I, the index value here. So let's add the I from above. Now we can get out our dictionary, so we'll say dictionary equals self.response list. We have the index value, which is at that I value, so we know what reply we want to actually send to the comment. We're going to do a try-catch block, because sometimes proc can return errors if you hit a rate limit or something like that. We don't want it to crash our program. So we'll do comment reply. We're going to pass in our dictionary, and this time we want to grab out the reply message. This is what we're going to say back to them. We're going to catch all exceptions. This is probably a no-no in most situations with programming. We're just going to catch any generic exception as E, and we'll print it out to the screen. I'm going to comment out so we're not actually making a reply yet, because we don't want to spam these. Let's just take a look at what phrase we did find. So we'll print out the phrase that we found, and we'll also print out what our reply would have been. And we can print out our comment.body as well. Awesome. We can leave it on all, because again, we're still not making comments yet. And now actually, after we comment, we want to make sure we update our last posted time as well. So we're going to say now equals datetime.now. And then we can do self.response list at the specific index we're working with. We want to add in a key of last posted or change whatever's there already. And we're going to set that equal to now, because this is the last time that this reply was sent now. Don't forget to add that I value into your parameters above there. Take care of that error. And now we're able to run and test this out. And you'll notice it finds something to pull in right away. You can see that it found my feelings in a post. And so it's going to reply with, "Fortunately, my feelings regenerate at twice the speed of a normal man's." Awesome. So it seems like it's working. Now again, remember, we have the comment value commented out right now, so it's not actually making the post. And we want to make sure we're doing something if it's not cooled down. So if the comment hasn't been 24 hours, we want to return false so we don't make a post. And then here, let's also print something out so we know that it didn't make a post. So I'm going to use an F string here. I'm going to say couldn't post. And then I'm going to spit out whatever phrase that I couldn't post. And I'm going to say where the cooldown value currently is. So how many hours do we have left to wait? And I'm missing a double quote at the end of this line. So I'll throw that in here. Just one. Now we can run this. And if we wait a little bit, you can see it couldn't post. Follow the rules. Cooldown time equals zero. So that was close. We want to do 24 minus hours. And now this will show you how many hours we have left to wait when it tries to make a post. Perfect. So we'll minimize that a little bit. Let's change this back to funny before we start actually making posts so we don't spam other ones. And you'll notice that we're also not going to be able to save our last posted times between runs. So if you kill this program like we did after it posted something and then run it again, it can post that exact same reply and be spammy. So we're going to use Repl.it's built-in database. So if you flip over to this database icon over here, we can grab out some of the code we need to use their database. Don't worry, we're not going to do too much here. We're literally just going to throw our entire response list into the database and then grab it out when we're done. That way, we'll have our last posted values. So you can see they want us to import it like this, so we'll just copy paste that in here. Now, when we initialize our bot, we're going to check to see if the length of the DB equals 0. We're going to grab all of our data out of our file. If it doesn't equal 0, that means we've posted to the database, so we're going to go ahead and use that instead of reading in our file. Oops, and don't forget to update our database. So we're going to say db square brackets response list equals self.response list. So our else case is if we do have a value in there already, I'm going to just print out a string so we know we're pulling from the database. And then below that, we can set up our self.response list equals db at the key of response list. Now we want to make sure when we're making a post and we're updating our last posted that we're also updating the database. So we're going to say down here db.response list equals self.response list. Now one thing that I do know here is that date times are not you can't serialize date times into JSON, which is what they use. So we're going to convert that to a timestamp with dot timestamp. And then up here, when we try to compare that value, we're going to have to convert it first from a timestamp. So up here, we're going to create a date time now. So we're going to say date time dot from timestamp and then pass in that dictionary, because now this is going to be a timestamp. And now everything should work like before, and our data should persist between runs. Now you can clear out this database if you want to add new key value pairs. I'll show you how to do that in a second, but it's just db.clear with parentheses. Take a quick look. Everything looks pretty good. Let's comment this out. And instead, we'll actually reply. We can go ahead and run this. And we're only doing funny here, so this is going to take a while. We're actually going to stop. I forgot. We're not going to know if we post. So we'll uncomment these again. That way we can see if we post. I'm actually going to move the comment above because it kind of sometimes the comments are long and hide everything else. And you can run this again. So now this bot will work. It will make posts when it finds it. Now note, we're only in funny, so there might not be that many matches. So if you don't get any matches, you can add more phrases or something like that. This will post a couple times a day, usually if I'm running it on funny, or you can pick a bigger subreddit if you'd like. If you want to add more phrases, remember you got to clear the database. So you can run this with our db.clear and then it'll clear out your database. But remember that will reset all your posted times as well. So we can do db.clear just like that. Now we're going to stop. And I'm going to comment that out. I don't want to do that right now, but I'll leave it here in case you need it. So we have some issues here. We want to keep the bot running 24/7 for free. If you're using the free version of Repl.it, it's going to shut down your script unless it's a web server. So we're basically going to make a fake web server here so it stays alive. So these files are pretty meaningless, so I'm not going to go over them. We're just going to copy and paste some files in here to make this a web server. So I'm going to grab this keep_alive.py. We'll open it up real quick, but essentially it's just making a Flask app that has nothing in it. So it'll just act like a web server. So we can close out of our Repl.it program and it'll still run our bot 24/7. So then if we move back to our main.py, we can import that function. So we're going to say from keep_alive, import keep_alive. And then we got to call that function below. And then hang with me, we got to do one more thing after that. So down here, we'll call that function to start the web server, keep_alive. This will add some garbage to us output into your console. So if you're debugging or things like that, you can always comment out the keep alive part. But you'll see here, it gives you a URL. Now we're going to use another free service to keep this alive. So after 2 hours, if no one visits this URL, Repl.it's going to shut down our web server. So we're going to use Uptime Robot. You can see it's here. It is uptimerobot.com. It's another free service. So we're going to register for free. Go ahead and get this set up with your credentials. Once you're finished, you should come to a screen like this. You can hit Add New Monitor, select HTTP. You can name it whatever you want. We're going to call ours Office Bot, and then you're going to paste in that URL we copied. You can set it to alert your email and then click close. So this is going to ping that URL however often you want. I think it's defaulted to every 5 minutes. We go into edit. Yeah, every 5 minutes. So this will keep our bot alive, and it'll also tell you if it crashes or something like that. So that's it. This bot should work. You can see that it's kind of working below. It's spitting out different things to the screen. The full code is on the GitHub. You can build it out from here. If there are any issues with it or anything like that, I'll update it in the comments. I'm going to add a sleep timer after we post for 3 hours here. So it's seconds. So I'm going to do time.sleep 60 seconds times 60 seconds in a minute. And I want it to sleep for 3 hours. So I'll put a 3 here. And then I'll import time from above. So this is going to make sure that it only makes one post every 3 hours. This will keep any rate limits or anything like that. Again, just so you don't get spammy. If you like this video, it really helps the channel. Every like and subscribe we get. If you don't mind, like and subscribe if you want to see more bots and programs like this. And until next time, keep coding.